check. Good morning. Oh, thanks for turning up on time, because that's what we've been trying to do since all of yesterday. If some of you were here yesterday, we're really making sure that sessions start and end on time. So your cooperation is really appreciated. Namaskara Matome, Ili Bandiruantha Yandrugu Swagata. My name is Vasanti Hariprakash. I'm an independent journalist in Anchor, and happy to be at BLF yet again under invite. The very first session of the second day of the Bangalore Literature Festival is beginning on a very intriguing note about a leader who interests us, intrigues us all the time. And we have a subject matter expert on this. So I'm not going to waste too much time, but straight away introduce our very first speaker of the day, Anuj Dhar. Let's hear it for him, Bangalore City. Anuj Dhar has researched the issue of Subhash Chandra Bose's mysterious disappearance for over a decade. His 2012 best-selling book, as we all know, India's Biggest Cover-Up, has triggered the demand for declassification of the Bose files straight away.
So thank you very much for giving the opportunity to be here and to keep my mind. Well, I'm letting you take you back to intolerant times. What, how we start? Well, I've been trying to see what we've done, but I've already seen what happened. Congress party is doing this thing. Brought any change in the attitude of the British government towards the issue of Indian independence. There was no change even after this end of the Second World War in the British view of Indian independence. They were not going to grant us a freedom. What happened after September 45? You had the INA trials, and you had these three, you know, heroes of INA, you know, they put on trial, Shahnawaz Khan, Dhillon and Sehgal. And then Congress Party, you know, sent their people to, you know, nooks and corners of India. They found out that people are very keen to know about, you know, Netaji, and they were supportive of him. So out of political reasons, you know, nothing else, because now we have been given a fantasy interpretation of history that Panditji took up the cause of INA for reason, in the national interest. No, I'm sorry, it was political. You have all records. That's a good thing. Declassification. There are a lot of documents which have been declassified now. So you have notes available. You have notes available in which you clearly see this thing coming through that. That the reason why the Indian National Congress, and Nehru in particular, went and tried to defend the INA people, basically political reasons. And it all, you know, busted apart when we had this, before the, you know, in 46, 47, you know, there used to be cries in Delhi, Lal Kile Se Aayi Awaaz, Sehlan Dhillon Shahnawaz, Inqilab Zindabad. And when 1947 came, Tryst with Destiny, not even once they took the name of Subhash Bose or the INA. In fact, they raised slogans in favor of England. England ki jai ho. Mountbatten ki jai ho. This is what happened in those days. And thereafter, what happened, independence, of course, we know this fellow's name was totally blocked out. You did not have his portrait in Parliament House until 1978. No statue, nothing. But it was only just Gandhi and Nehru. I mean, we were fed with all this throughout. Now, I am coming to more to my own times. Now, this was in 2004 or 5. We had this Mukherjee Commission functioning, and we were like, from my point of view, misfortune that the Congress Party came back to power. So we knew that something is going to go wrong. Now that the Congress Party is in power, in fact, one of the decisions the party took the soon after they took over is to tell Justice Mukherjee to wind up his inquiry. So we knew that something bad is going to happen. Chidambaram was the one who made a statement on behalf of the Indian cabinet. I mean, you have just come to power. What's your problem? So we knew something's wrong. So in those days, we did not even have Facebook. So me and a couple of my friends, we got together. I'm talking about pre-Facebook days, so we have this internet chat room. So we got together. Something has to be done. Something has to be done. Me sitting in Delhi, Shantan is in Delhi, Chandrachud was in London, Vishal was in Delhi, Shrijit is in Kerala. So we all thought something has to be done. So we said, we got to do something. We just can't let it go, just like that. And then we regular people, nothing to flaunt, nothing special we had. I was a poor student of history, of course, all my life, but I was a journalist, of course. I had written a book about Subhash Bose, and I had some insight about the whole issue. I said, we got to go, you know, do something about this particular case. So we started, and we formed a group called Mission Netaji, and said, look, we have a problem. I don't think so in this, and I this is my view, that in this age and time, they were talking about 2004, it is not possible to get the attention of mainstream historians or journalists or anybody for that matter to the issue of Subhash Bose's death mystery. They would not be interested. They are not bothered about it. In fact, none of these historians, you know, talking big these days, not even one of them, not even once they had a whimper of protest that you're keeping so many files classified about Subhash Bose. We thought we must highlight a demand. An opportunity came our way when we had this, the last government, UPA government, enacted the Right to Information Act, 2005. I said, now we have got our chance. In fact, Chandrachud, when he was in UK, he said, no, let's do this thing. He was the one who came up with the idea. I was not very clean. I said, no, why should we do it? Because I don't see any chance of this government giving us any document or any file. I mean, they simply would say no to us, national security clause. Then it occurred to me, yes, if they're going to say no to not to giving us a document, it will probably make more news. Because media, as you know, I was part of media. In media, negative news, of course, has more value than positive news at times. So let's give it a shot. So in 2005, we filed a simple application with the Ministry of Home Affairs. By that time, Justice Manoj Mukherjee Commission of Inquiry report had been released by the government and rejected without assigning any reason. And subsequently, there was a debate in Parliament, and these people concluded. The then Home Minister, Shivraj Patil, he made a statement that we are accepting the findings of previous committee and commission, that is Shahnawaz Committee and G.D. Khosla Commission, not of Subhash Bose, Justice Mukherjee. Of course, he wouldn't tell you that Shahnawaz Khan was a Congress Party member of Parliament. He wouldn't tell you that G.D. Khosla was a friend of Mr. Nehru's. So that subtext is missing from the entire debate which took place in Parliament. So we knew that we can just blow hole in their entire, you know, argument. So a simple request was made to the Ministry of Home Affairs, which is the nodal ministry in the Subhash Bose death matter, that you give us the exhibits used by Justice D.D. Khosla and Shahnawaz, Mr. Shahnawaz, to write the reports. Exhibits are documents which are used by any committee or commission of inquiry to arrive at a conclusion. So this is all we ask for. So we make this demand. And outcome within, I think, barely 15 days onwards, we received a reply from the Ministry of Home Affairs that these papers can't be given because it's national security information. Good Lord, in the name of God, I mean, 2005, you are keeping files about Subhash Bose classified, national security? And this guy obviously freaked out. So he, you know, normally when you are giving an answer in the RTI, you're supposed to give your reasons why you can't give information. The clauses are given. And in case you are not able to justify, then you have to give the name of the appellate authority within the ministry. In case you are not happy with the answer, please go to this gentleman, he will give another answer. This fellow obviously was, you know, he had of course lost his, you know, I think bearings when he was writing the answer. He did not give us the reasons, you know, why he's doing so. So then of course we went straight to the Central Information Commission. Now this is the background of what has happened since April this month, because there have been a lot of talks. I've been on television in studios. People have been making these wild statements. Okay, this is being done by the BJP. There have been some selective leaks in media. I'm sorry, please go to the history of whole case. You know how it started. I'm telling you how it started. Central Information Commission, Wajahat Hibbullah was the Chief Information Commissioner. Our matter went to Mr. Tiwari, who was the Information Commissioner. And the ministry people came to us in the first hearing before Mr. Tiwari. They said that we do not have any list of exhibits which were produced before either Mr. Khosla or Mr. Shahnawaz. Well, we were given a dressing down by Mr. Tiwari. He said, why are you people wasting your time? You should be, you know, utilizing the RTI Act for some good things. Why are you just bothered about some old dead issue and, you know, this which is no concern? Well, in the next hearing, I produced a classified list of exhibits used by Khosla. This is Khosla. I mean, here you have the ministry officials coming and telling commission on record, we have no such list. And in the next hearing, I produced a classified list. And what this guy did was, from the ministry, he said, where did you get this thing from? I said, you were the one who said last time there's no such list. And then Mr. Tiwari understood. Then he ordered, you must give these documents. There were 202 items. You must supply these documents to these people. Matter didn't get settled. It went to the extraordinary bench of the Central Information Commission. I think in those days, of course, Ajad Saab was the head. Mr. Tiwari was there. Dr. O.P. Kejriwal, former director of the Nehru Memorial Library, eminent historian. He was also the editor of the Gandhi collected works when they were released in 1997, I believe. So these eminent historians, you have these people from the government side. I think Mr. Tiwari was a secretary. I think it is some secretary in the government of India before he retired. There, the Home Ministry made certain submissions on record, which are very important even today, because as we see, because yesterday, the day for yesterday, the Prime Minister's office has released 33 files, I'm given to understand. Now, this is very important. What happened next? Now, this is part of record. When this hearing was taking place, the then Home Secretary, V.K. Duggal, he sent a letter, and this letter was placed on record, and they admitted ki the Home Ministry was holding something like 70,000 pages concerning Subhash Bose's fate. 70,000. It is part of record. You can go to internet, Google it, you'll find it. 70,000 pages concerning Subhash's death were available with Ministry of Home Affairs. Of these, they maintain some papers are so sensitive that if disclosed, quote, it may lead to law and order problem across the country, especially in West Bengal, unquote. That is the reason given by the nodal ministry in the times of Congress Party in 2000, I believe it was 5 or 6, that these files can't be given to us. And then, of course, you know, thereafter the commission took our side and gave clear instruction, you know, these papers that we are asking for 202 must be given to us. And also that these 70,000 pages that the ministry is holding, these must be sent to the National Archive. So these were two orders made by the Information Commission headed by Mr. Wajad Habibullah. This is the history of what has happened since April this month. And so what happened that, you know, the ministry did not obey the order properly. They gave us only 90 out of 202 documents, which means that the most sensitive stuff was not given to us. All in sundry papers. Of course, there were some of them were good enough, but most sensitive data was withheld, not given to us. And eventually in 2010, they released out of these 70,000 pages, some 10,000 pages were released and sent to the National Archive in Delhi. So this is the background of what happened recent time, because when you make this allegation that the BJP is releasing all this information, that's what how it happened. In 2010, the then government of India released certain papers. Out of the lot of 70,000, 10,000 was sent to the National Archive. Now, when you send stuff to National Archive, it takes certain time before it is processed and made available for researchers to take a look at. The process was completed in 2014, November, and it was in December last year that I went to the archive and I started to take a look at these papers. I had already in my previous book, 2012, India's Biggest Group, I had hinted that I was aware that there was an incident of spying on the members of Subhash Bose's family. I had given some about 3-4 paragraphs about it. I was able to access one classified document hinting at the possibility that people were being stooped upon, you know, in those days. But when I was sitting at the National Archive taking a look at these, you know, 10,000 pages, you know, what happens is, when you make a disclosure of, let's say, thousands of pages, sometimes by mistake you end up releasing something which should not, you know, be released. Evidently, by mistake, they released several documents from the West Bengal side, government side, intelligence department, and there were, of course, many documents which were from the central government also. Now, when I was taking a look at these papers, I mean, suddenly, you know, I'm thinking of Watergate scandal and Nixon. Now, what happened? You know, we all talk about, you know, every time there's some scandal in India, we just suffix this gate after it. Coal gate, that gate, what gate? What is gate? It's Watergate. Watergate is what? Mr. Nixon tried to snoop upon his political adversaries, and he fumbled in the very first attempt. And he has become, you know, is bandied about for all times to come. They could not even put a bug in the offices of the Democratic Party. They got caught. That is Watergate. Now here, when I'm looking at these papers, right from 1948 to 71, no manner of doubt, clear cut at the instruct of the Intelligence Bureau in Delhi, you are keeping an eye on everybody concerning Subhash Bose, his nears and dears one, people from the INA. And it was happening across states. There was one record from Chennai. There was one record, of course, from Punjab, Maharashtra. They were snooping on everybody. I mean, I took a look at it, and I think that Mr. Nixon was a novice compared to Mr. Nehru. He got caught in the first go. Imagine the manner in which they did it. 25 years. And, you know, funny thing, eminent historians are coming on television. Even Sugata Bose, Netaji's family, his father was in Congress Party, his mother was in Congress Party. That he will never tell you. He comes and they are all making, no, Panditji was not aware of it. Some lowly officers, you know, must have done it. अरे बाबा आपको क्या मालूम है इंटेलिजेंस ब्यूरो के बारे में. आर एन काव वॉज अ लोली ऑफिसर. बी एन मलिक वॉज अ लोली ऑफिसर. आपको मालूम है बी एन मलिक किस चीज़ का नाम था. मिस्टर हुजा कौन थे मालूम है. 67 में डीआईबी थे वो. आपको मालूम है डीआईबी का मतलब क्या होता है इस देश में. डायरेक्टर इंटेलिजेंस ब्यूरो आपका बाप होता है वहाँ दिल्ली के अंदर. आप समझते हैं कि आपका देश जो है गांधी जी के आइडिया से चलता है. हम इतने वी आर पास्ट मास्टर्स. यू नो व्हेन वी हैड दिस थिंग Edward Snowden controversy, you would recall, India was the only country which did not protest too much. In fact, Mr. Khurshid justified it. Now we know why. We have been doing the same thing. What is big deal in putting people under surveillance? Now, West Bengal government, they have also now under compulsion. Now they have released, you know, their 64 files. Now snooping is confirmed. Mamata Banerjee has publicly said it. She was not interested in issue to start because she also had her career with political Congress Party. But she was forced to admit because now records are available. And now you take a look at them. In fact, if I had time, I would have shown you these images, you know, documents and all that. I was challenging people in America where I was in last month. I was challenging them, please show me anything in the entire controversy of Watergate. Give me example of this sort. I gave them example. There was a boy who was around in the ninth class, Prithvi Lal Subba. He wrote a letter to Subhash Bose's brother, wanting to know in 1949 whether Netaji is alive or not. And these people started snooping on him also. Ninth class boy. Netaji's teenage nieces were not spared. And people who were members of parliament, people who were former ministers, they were also not spared. This is the level to which they stooped. And all the while we have been given this gibberish that people were Democrats. In fact, B.N. Malik, you know, did a wonderful thing. He wrote a book about my years with Nehru, published in 1970s, in which he also, because he was part of the whole, you know, this gang, you know, they were trying to portray Panditji as a great Democrat. You know, as a parliament house was built by Pandit Nehru. Arey, Baba, 1935 ka act aap logon ne chep diya tha, cut and paste kiya, usme aapka role kya usme? Angrez ne banaya aapko independent, aapko wo diya aapko democracy banayi hai. Kal ko aap ye dawa thok do ke sara Rashtrapati Bhavan bhi humne banaya. Arey, Angrez kya banaya hua? Aap kahan se beech mein aa gaye? Aapne usko thoda aage badhaya, theek hai, you were a Democrat. उसने एग्जांपल दिया कि पंडित जी इतने डेमोक्रेट थे कि जब उनको मैंने बोला कि कोई फॉरेन हमारी मिनिस्ट्री है हमारी वहाँ पे लोग जासूसी कर रहे हैं तो वी शुड पुट अ स्पाई ऑन दीज फॉरेन डिप्लोमेट्स. इस पंडित जी वाज अगेंस्ट इट. इतना डेमोक्रेटिक थे कि साहब फॉरेन कंट्री के ऊपर भी काउंटर इंटेलिजेंस नहीं करेंगे हम लोग. आप देखिए अब कागज निकल के आ रहे हैं कि अपने घर के लोगों पर जासूसी चल रही है. वर्स्ट इनका प्रॉब्लम हो गया कि लास्ट ईयर अगेन टू द मिसफॉर्चून ऑफ गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया इन लास्ट कपल ऑफ ईयर सम न्यू थिंग्स हैव कम आउट फ्रॉम द यूके साइड. एक आपकी ऑफिशियल हिस्ट्री ऑफ MI5 MI6 हैव कम आउट. नाउ वी नो फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू नो वट दिस डूबियस थिंग विच हैपन कॉल्ड ट्रांसफर ऑफ पावर इन 1946-47 की लड़ाई लड़ी आपकी सुभाष बोस ने आईएनए की और ये खीर खा गए कांग्रेसी. लड़ाई वड़ाई तो उनसे होती थी नहीं उन जमाने से. 42 के बाद से बैठे हुए चुपचाप. क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट से आपको आज़ादी मिली है आपको. अरे भैया क्विट इंडिया मूवमेंट आपका 2 महीने में खत्म हो गया था. आपका 43 में कौन सा मूवमेंट चल रहा था आपका. आपने ट्रांसफर पावर किया उसके अंदर एक सीक्रेट क्लॉज थी. दे वुड बी हैविंग ए सिक्योरिटी लियाजन ऑफिसर इन दिल्ली. MI5 का SLO बैठेगा. SLO वाज़ ए माई बाप. वो माई बाप आपका यहाँ बैठा था 1968 तक. और रोज सुबह जाकर के आपका IB का डायरेक्टर माई बाप को सलूट मारता था कि साहब क्या बताइए मेरे लिए क्या काम करना है. ये आ गया राइटिंग में आ गया. शरण नाम की चीज है. उनको सुबह शाम गाली देते हैं अंग्रेजों को आपके अंग्रेज ने आपको लूट दिया ये करते. उसका SLO आपने यहाँ बैठा दिया. सुबह शाम उसको सलूट मार रहे बता रहे देखो ये इन्फॉर्मेशन है आपके बारे में. जितने आपके कम्युनिस्ट भाई थे यहाँ पे इंडिया के कम्युनिस्ट पार्टी उनके स्टूपिंग करके इन्फॉर्मेशन उनको सप्लाई करते थे ये लोग. ये तो पब्लिक में आ गया. नाउ आई फाउंड समथिंग मच मोर यू नो बिनो सेवियर. दे वर स्पाइंग ऑन सुभाष बोस फैमिली एंड इज नियर एंड डियर्स वन एंड सप्लाइंग इन्फॉर्मेशन अबाउट देम टू द ब्रिटिश MI5. दिस इज आप बात कर रहे हैं टॉलरेंस की. ट्रीजन है भैया. टॉलरेंस क्या चीज होती है वो तो बच्चों का खेल है. टॉलरेंस इनटॉलरेंस की डिबेट चल रही है आजकल. ट्रीजन. जिस आदमी ने आपको फ्रीडम दिलाई है वो आदमी मर गया है कि जिंदा है, अलग अलग थ्योरियां चल रही हैं। सुब्रमण्यम स्वामी यहाँ पर आए थे आपके पिछले महीने में, दिल्ली में मैं काम करता हूँ, दिल्ली में रहता हूँ, आप इवन कांग्रेस पार्टी के लोग प्राइवेटली एडमिट करते हैं कि वो रूस में था। वो इट इज अ कॉमन नॉलेज इन दिल्ली, पीपल ओपनली टॉक अबाउट इट इन प्राइवेट, यू नो, इन जर्नलिस्ट इंटेलिजेंस, वो ही वॉज इन रशिया, वॉज किल्ड बाय नेहरू। आई एम सॉरी, गॉड फॉरबिड दिस शुड बी ट्रू। आपका आदमी जिसने आपको आजादी में लड़ाई में जिसने आपको इंडिपेंडेंस दिलाया, वो बेचारा उधर गया, यहां मरा, वहां मरा, आप उसकी इंक्वायरी नहीं करेंगे, कुछ नहीं करेंगे आप लोग? ऊपर से आप जस्टिस को ऑब्स्ट्रक्ट करेंगे। और बेचारे निक्सन ने क्या किया था? ऑब्स्ट्रक्शन ऑफ जस्टिस। एग्जाम्पल देता हूँ आपको मैं, चाचा नेहरू की बात कर रहे हैं थोड़ी सी और। सन 56 में आपकी शाहनवाज कमेटी बनाएगी पब्लिक प्रेशर में, गवर्नमेंट के जो रिकॉर्ड जो निकल के जो आएंगे आपको, एक चीज़ में आप याद रखिए, अभी 33 फाइल्स पीएमओ के आएंगे, मैंने कुछ ऑलरेडी देखी हुई है वहाँ पे। ये फाइलों में गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का इंटरप्रिटेशन है इशूज़ के ऊपर, दैट इज नॉट गॉस्पल ट्रुथ, इट्स नॉट गीता और कुरान विच इज देयर इन द प्राइम मिनिस्टर्स ऑफिस इन दीज रिकॉर्ड्स। ऑफिशियल्स व्यूज आर गिवन देयर एंड दीज आर कलर्ड व्यूज। I have seen some of these notes by Home Secretaries and Foreign Secretaries. So what they're writing there? They're writing, for example, in 1955, Government of India set up Shahnawaz Committee. No, you did not set up, my dear fellow. There was a gun put against a temple. You were least bothered. In 1946, Pandit Nehru made a statement. Subhash Chandra Bose tried in a plane crash in Taiwan. There was no more debate allowed. You formed this committee because there was public pressure against you. Number two, Shahnawaz wanted to have an inquiry done at the place of the, you know, where there was an alleged plane crash with Subhash Bose. Because there are three theories of Subhash Chandra Bose's death as we know them today. There was no, he died in a plane crash in Taiwan 1945. Two, that he, and this is according to likes of Subramanian Swami, he was in Russia where he was killed in 1953-54. God forbid this should be true. And third, that he was a holy man, he was in India. So these are three theories available. So the first theory was, of course, dominant throughout, was the plane crash theory. And Shahnawaz wanted to go to Taiwan and have an on-the-spot inquiry done. That's very obvious. You have a murder taking place in Bangalore. You can't do the inquiry, in Lhasa. You have to come to Bangalore. He wanted to go. Then, of course, you have this correspondence available. I access, I produce copies in my books also. And the government said, no, you cannot go there because we do not have diplomatic relation with Taiwan. In fact, that excuse is being carried on until our times. Hey, Baba, we have intelligence ties with Taiwan government. We spy on Chinese using these people. We have given a very wrong impression about India to the rest of the world. You know, the spying happens in America. You have secret bunkers in America. Are Delhi mein nahi hai kya bunker kya? Aap samajhte hain aapka desh, wo main repeat kar raha hu, aapka desh Mahatma Gandhi ke adde pe nahi chalta, wo raw IB wale chalate hain, security chalte hain. Gandhi ji to bolte the army disband kar do. To zarurat kya hai cheezon ki? Ahimsa jo hai wo atom bomb se badi taakat hai. Karyappa saab gaye the na, General Karyappa had met Mr. Gandhi before he went to Kashmir. Gandhi said, don't need to fight. Please follow, obey him. Government is talking so much about following Gandhi's ideal thesis. Please follow it in letter and spirit. Gandhiji was completely against violence. He didn't want the armed forces. He didn't want industry also. Follow him completely. Now, you have this 56 problem that they have this excuse that we don't have a diplomatic relation with the government of Taiwan. And then the proposal comes and we have a certain fellow called T.N. Kaul involved in the entire picture. He was a relative of Mr. Nehru, who eventually became a foreign secretary and ambassador to Russia and America. Now T.N. Kaul suggests, no, what we can do, we can ask either Japanese or ask the British. They have some diplomatic ties with the Taiwanese government. We can find out from them what exactly is there. So certain queries were made through the British High Commission in Delhi to the Taiwanese authorities regarding Subhash Chandra Bose's death. And that report was completed by the British and sent to Government of India, and it was received, I think, 7 days after, because Shahnawaz was in a great hurry to produce his report. 6-7 days after Shahnawaz submitted a report to Prime Minister Nehru, this report was received from the British side, and the sum and substance of that report is that probably Subhash Chandra Bose did not die in that plane crash. One. From that time till today, that thing does not exist on the Indian side. Nobody wants to talk about it. When Mukherjee Commission was set up and the government, the Ministry of External Affairs was obliged to supply information to the government of India in those days, they did not submit this particular report coming from the Taiwanese side. Now, their misfortune, after 30 years, the British government declassified their lot. Now you go to queue in London, go to the archives, and you have that file there. On the last page of the file, it clearly says, this gentleman, whoever the representative here in Delhi, the High Commission, is this fellow saying, I went to the Indian Ministry of External Affairs and submitted 5 copies of this report. No, Baba, you had 5 copies of this report in 1956 given to Mr. Nehru, who was the Minister of External Affairs in those days, making it somewhat clear that Subhash Chandra Bose did not die. You did nothing about it. You just hushed it up. Even Nixon did not do no such thing. You simply hush it up, and you are being touted all over the world that truth, ahimsa, non-violence. What is this joke happening? So this, I think time has come. In fact, even I was talking to people in the BJP. They're very tolerant towards Congress as of now. They should have got the whole hog. INA treasure. The story that the INA treasure went missing. You know, now we know secret government of India records clearly suggesting there were 2-3 people who were involved in the loot. This is the war chest. Sacred money, people, you know, women gave away their jewelry so that you can wage fight for the Indian freedom struggle. That sacred money was looted. 4-5 people have been identified in the government files. You can't touch Mr. Figgis because he's a British citizen. You can't touch the Japanese. The two people, one is in Chennai, the other one is in India. You don't touch them, and what you do, and Mr. Nehru is aware because these are signed notes. He's aware. He's told again and again, Mr. Iyer is responsible for the loot, Mr. Ramamurthy is responsible for the loot. Knowing very well that Iyer is part of the loot, he gives him a position in the PM Secretariat, which was the then PMO known as, and he makes him the in charge of the publicity of the Panchvarshiya Yojana, Pradhan Mantri ki Panchvarshiya Yojana jo hoti thi uske bare mein. You are rewarding a thief. And we get to hear so many things, you know, in Parliament House, you know, in the good old days. ये ऐसे होता था, ऐसे होता था, क्या होता था? So I think I don't know this. So what's going to happen now? That when the files are going to be brought out, these issues are going to get spotlighted one by one. And another area which I think would be interested, you know, I would be very keen to look at in great detail, is the role played by the bureaucracy in the entire game. I have seen several notes. Several top level, you know, secretaries. You have Padmana Bhaiya was there, the Home Secretary, Shyam Saran, who eventually became Foreign Secretary, K.R. Narayan, who became India's Foreign, he was a big shot, then he became our country's President. Pranab Mukherjee, of course, he was the Minister of Foreign Affairs. So you have all these people, you know, diplomats and ministers. I give example, Shyam Saran, you know, I saw a noting by him there was a note in 1993, something like that. Shyam Saran, he's a very intelligent man, speaks with American accent, English, you know, he's a very intelligent fellow, it seems. Now, you are writing in an official note that nothing would be found in the National Archives, Intelligence Archive. How do you know? I mean, sitting in Delhi, you're making deduction, nothing would be found there. Who has told you nothing would be found there? It should be open, yeah. Are you serving, serving a country or serving a family? Without asking, there's a simple case. Whether Netaji was in Russia or not after his death, you don't have to go to historians. They will only make the whole issue, you know, they will muddy the water further, as they have been done for past so many years. Because not one of them ever demanded declassification. It's people like me and my friends, the regular folks who demanded declassification. Whether Subhash Bose was in Russia or not, there's only one simple way to do that. You ask Russians, they are your friends, and which you never did. From 1947, there were many reasons, there are intelligence reports. There were all kind of horrendous allegations. That, for example, that your Radhakrishnan was our ambassador in Russia and he came to know something. That's why, and that's the reason for his eminence in India. He came to know of a high value of information and he comes to Delhi and suddenly he's made India's vice president. And somebody in cabinet says, ki kya hum sab mar gaye, ye kahan se paida ho gaya banne ke liye vice president. आप उनसे पूछेंगे ना रशियन से कि साहब वो आदमी आपके पास में था कि नहीं था, आपने नहीं पूछा. बड़े बड़े यहाँ पे लीडर थे, स्टेट वर्ल्ड लीडर्स थे, गांधी जी, राहुल गांधी, सॉरी राजीव गांधी, पंडित नेहरू, इंदिरा गांधी. एक बार भी, और ये उस जमाने की बात मैं कर रहा हूँ आपसे, जो लोग छोटे हैं उनको समझ में नहीं आएगा, हिंदुस्तान के और रशिया के रिलेशनशिप ऐसा था कि गोबर गैस प्लांट से एटम बम सब कुछ वहीं से बन के आता था हमारा. पूरी आर्मी में अगर वो रशियन अगर आपका सामान देना छोड़ देते ना उस जमाने में, तो तलवार भरे निकल जाते हमारे महाभारत की टाइम की तरह. कुछ नहीं बनता था यहाँ पे. इतनी आपकी उनसे इतनी अच्छी दोस्ती थी, आपने उनसे एक बार भी नहीं पूछा, बॉस की ये बंदा आपके पास में था कि नहीं था, हमारा देश का बड़ा लीडर था, दुनिया भर की हमको रिपोर्ट्स मिल रही है कि आपके पास में है कि नहीं है, आपने नहीं पूछा. बड़ी मुश्किल से जाकर के एक मिस्टर नारायणन थे, जॉइंट सेक्रेटरी आपके मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स के अंदर, he was in charge of the East European Division. तो उस मिस्टर नारायणन ने ये प्रपोजल मूट किया कि साहब आप रशियंस तो हमें ऐसे बताएंगे नहीं, हम उनसे को उनको डिमांड इशू करते हैं, उनसे पूछते हैं कि साहब आपके पास में जो KGB की फाइल्स हैं क्या सुभाष बोस का उसमें नाम है कि नहीं है, उनका कुछ उनके बारे में कुछ जिक्र है कि नहीं है, क्योंकि पहले जो हमारे इंटरेक्शन हुए वो इतने अच्छे नहीं हुए. अब वो प्रपोजल उस जमाने के फॉरेन सेक्रेटरी ने देखा, सलमान हैदर, ये आपके समधी हैं सुब्रमण्यम स्वामी, कहते हैं वो मेंशन करना भूल गए थे कि मेरे समधी भी इस केस में है. और उसके बाद में वो प्रणब बाबू ने देख लिया. अब प्रणब बाबू जो दुनिया भर में ढंडोरा पीटता कि मैं सुभाष चंद्र बोस का भक्त हूँ मैं, अरे बाबा मैं आपको रिकॉर्ड दिखा दूंगा CIA के, वो कांग्रेस पार्टी का भक्त है, वो दैट इज वाई सिटिंग ऑन दैट इन दैट पोजिशन. वहाँ जाकर के इन लोगों ने उस कटल कर दिया प्लान. और बेशर्मी की हद देखिए कि आप उसके बाद राष्ट्रपति बनने के बाद में जी मैं तो नेताजी का भक्त हूँ, अरे भैया मेरे आप नेताजी के भक्त थे, आपके सामने जो प्रपोजल आया था कि रूस गवर्नमेंट से पूछा जाए कि वो आदमी आपके पास में था कि नहीं था, तो आपने उसमें क्यों उसमें आपने गुटली लगाई, उसके अंदर आपने कड़ंगी लगा दी, आपने अलाउ नहीं किया उसको, बड़ी बड़ी बातें मार रहे हैं आके टेलीविजन में, अभी परसों में कहते गांधी आश्रम में कहते कि वो दिमाग में साफ होना चाहिए, ये क्या फाइल निकालो बाहर, अभी देखो इनकी सफाई होती सबकी के करके. तो ये माहौल मेरा एक जो मैं आपको ये घुमा फिरा करके आई एम गोइंग इन द हियर एंड देयर हेल्टर स्केल्टर इज प्लीज डोंट कंसिडर दिस टू बी एन इशू ऑफ जस्ट हिस्ट्री. It is going to have a tremendous impact on Indian polity, Indian politics, bureaucracy, intelligence. I recall day for yesterday, let me not spare the BJP also. The question was put in parliament by Sukhendu Shekhar Roy of the Trinamool Congress. How many files these ministries have got regarding Subhash Bose? Ministry of Home Affairs, External Affairs Ministry. So some data has given. Now, surprisingly, that according to my knowledge, the MEA had something like 28 files about Subhash Bose. But now they're saying 90 files we have got. That's news to me. Number two, the Ministry of Home Affairs is claiming that they have got 3 files on Subhash Chandra Bose, which are classified. This is strange because we were given to understand that they were holding 70,000 pages. 70,000 pages can't be 3 files, and 70,000 out of 10,000 have been released. And the Home Secretary's note was very clear. There are papers, if disclosed, may lead to law and order problem across the country, especially in West Bengal. So there have to be papers available with the Ministry of Home Affairs, which, if disclosed, will create problems across the country. Where are those papers? We'll come to know. Now, then they say we have 2 files and that's all. But I want to ask, isn't IB part of the Ministry of Home Affairs? I know there are 77 files. We have before Mukherjee Commission, there was an affidavit, secret affidavit filed by the IB. I have got a copy of it. I can give you a list of 77 files with the IB, including those of spying also. How can you give an answer in parliament? I mean, IB function under the British government. What world are we living in? You want to know truth about any issue, Netaji Ministry, anything, please go to the intelligence archive first. I went to see this MI6 head office in the UK. Well, it's an impressive building, architecture is very, very good, but be under no mism, IB raw office also very good. It's not bad either. So the declassification has been taken up in right earnest by this government because, way back in 2004, me and my friends, we flagged the issue. Then we go to the Netaji family. We said, no, you need to come out, hit the streets. You have Jessica Lal issue. You have this Arushi Talwar case where people come out in the street demanding justice, draw attention of media. We need to do the same thing. There's no other way you can get attention people the way we're going about it. So the family and we started carrying out these marches in Calcutta. And this is how the whole thing built up in those days. Election was around the corner. So the BJP made commitment that when they're in power, they'll do something. And Modi ji, I was aware that he was personally interested about this matter, even when he was the Chief Minister of Gujarat. So this is how the whole thing built up. Now, in right earnest, the government has decided to order declassification. So 33 files, day for yesterday, I'm told, out of 41 classified files, which PMO has got, they admit, 33 files are being released to the National Archive and they'll be available on January 23rd. I welcome it, but we want all 41. Nothing should be held back. We are a country which believes in Satyamev Jayate. Our national emblem is there. We are a country whose father of nation was Mahatma Gandhi, and Mahatma Gandhi said, truth is above God. So first of all, the declassification has to be comprehensive. It must include all the intelligence files. Without documents coming from IB and RAW, we will not reach the truth. Because we know there are papers with intelligence organizations about this whole matter. It's true. I want to give you a very interesting, insight into the secrecy, how the things function at the minister level. government level, there are essentially two types of files which exist with Government of India, even other governments also. In America, conspiracy theories, they talk of above top secret. There is no such thing as above top secret. What you have, that you have certain information so highly sensitive that it's kept separately. It is not part of the record. Now, when the Prime Minister's office says that we have got 41 files, what they mean is that in the Prime Minister's office, that is the South Block, in the record room, they have got around something like 30,000 files they're holding, classified files. And they've got 41 files which are clearly about Subhash Bose. What they are not telling you is that there are certain files which are kept, which are in Prime Minister's custody, but physical custody is given to other agencies. Like RAW is holding certain files, and they talk to only Prime Minister, and they don't believe any in law of the land. IB and RAW, they are above law. They can work beyond the remit of law in this land. And there are the most highly secretive files of India are kept under the personal custody of the Prime Minister of the country. These are not part of the PMO record room, which our section office is in charge of. I have put a very clear question to the Prime Minister in my book. I have given my reasons also. You must include those categories of files also, and then make a comprehensive declassification. Declassification, the way it's happening right now, I'm sure, because Prime Minister said after 23rd January, we will start. We will go step by step. I'm fine with it. I prefer, the approach, given the approach of jhatka and halal, I'll prefer the halal in this case. Do it slowly, it's fine, good for us. But then do it, go the whole hog. Declassify everything, start with these 33, then go to 41, but then we must have the intelligence files. And this snooping scandal must be, taken into account, and there has to be accountability, has to be fixed. Yes, people are dead and gone, but many are still alive. You cannot spy on your own people. So this is how these are some of the issues. I thought I'll speak for not more than half an hour, and then because it's an hour I've been given, it would be better if we have an interactive session. So I'm sure many of you would have questions and I can answer, and then recording, I'll get time to answer those questions. This gentleman there.
I have a question. So here.
Yeah.
So why would you think that the previous government would want to suppress the death of Netaji? I mean, why would they want to do that?
There was one original sin was made. See, problem is a very complex problem. I think the original sin was made in 1946 when Pandit Nehru, when he was the interim prime minister of the country, he made a statement that Subhash Chandra Bose has died in the plane crash. Initially, he had his doubts. Gandhiji has his doubt, and now we have, in fact, documents available clearly suggesting Gandhiji knew he was in Russia, and he kept mum. So there's a when Nehru made this statement, then the entire machinery, entire apparatus of the state, and all state historians, it became their duty to prove Mr. Nehru right. We cannot imagine, as I said, that in a literary festival, you're letting me talk about Netaji mystery. You couldn't imagine these things happening even 2 years earlier. In the times of Indira Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhiji and Chacha Nehru, if you dared to do such a thing, they would have sent the IB's people after your life. So things were not conducive. Now, question can be put, why did not the previous BJP government do it? A, the question was not flagged. Politician needs to have something in media to be, to the action. I am given to understand that yes, Mr. Vajpayee was keen. Vajpayee was under some kind of apprehension that he will win the elections, which he did not. So he had set this commission because there was a court order, and he was good enough to set it. That's why I always say that I give BJP 50 out of 100 marks. Rest 50 will depend upon what they do next. Either they'll also get zero or they'll get 50 more. Vajpayee at least set the commission up. And he was of the idea that probably once when we come to power next time, because by the time the elections came on the 2001, commission work was almost finished. So that's one. Nobody flagged the entire issue. It has become a big issue only now in recent times. And there are several complications. Subramaniam Swami makes the whole issue very simple when we say that the whole case, if the truth is brought out, will hit only Mr. Nehru. No, it is going to hit many. I've just given some names. Many bureaucrats. In fact, I'm sorry, it is going to hit Mr. Gandhi also. It's going to hit a lot of people. Now, which government in this country would have the guts to do something? I give example. There is a file in the Prime Minister's office. I give you two examples. It suffice. Why even Mr. Modi will think 100 times? There is a file, secret file. I don't think so it is part of the 33 files. Prime Minister will not release it unless until, there's a mistake taking place. There are two files in the Prime Minister's office. One of the files has a noting in which an eminent American journalist who was a friend of Gandhiji, and he had met Gandhiji in July 1946. After his meeting, Louis Fisher, I'm talking about, Pulitzer Award winner. After his meeting with Gandhiji, a certain clarification is being sent to Louis Fisher from Gandhiji's side. And it is stated there, if Subhash Bose comes back from Russia, Congress party and Gandhi will not be able to reason with the country. So which means Gandhi was aware of Netaji's presence in Russia and he kept his mouth shut for whatever reasons. Number two, there is, now this is all the more serious thing. Now there is a file in which there is a letter written by the then external affairs minister who is our president right now, Mr. Pranab Mukherjee. What he has done that in that record, he has given the wrong data, which is a serious crime. If you were to change your name in your ration card, the government will haul you over coals. Now this man is writing a lie there that in 1994 I went to Germany. I met Subhash Bose's wife and she agreed to my proposal that the so-called Asher Subhash Chandra Bose from Russia, from Japan would be brought to India. She never accepted that sort of thing. Why are you writing a lie in official record? See, clearly writes. So once you bring the whole thing out, it is going to hit the country's president also. Can the prime minister of the country do something which will put the country's president in some kind of jeopardy? So there'll be a lot of problems. So these problems are there in previous time also. So I think the only chance we had last time was Mr. Vajpayee, because before that, Narasimha Rao wouldn't have done it. The others like I.K. Gujral were there for a short period. V.P. Singh was only for 2 years. They were also not very too keen about Subhash Bose also. So the first real chance we're getting is right now. I think our best chance is next year now. So next year when the things start to roll, only then we will reach the whole thing. But the series of reasons, compulsions, it is going to implicate many people, not just Mr. Nehru. That's a problem.
Hey, Anuj. Thanks.
So he's already asked. Even in countries like America, John F. Kennedy and all that, his death, CIA has not disclosed the complete files. And why do you think Netaji's files, if it brings destruction to the country, why should it be declassified?
I think Kennedy, the only files which have not been left out are very personal, that, you know, there are certain comments by his wife and etc. Most of the files have been made public, Kennedy, after we have this movie called JFK. There's a controversy and we had this JFK Records Act in America and they've declassified almost everything. Only very few, very highly sensitive, certain comments about by his wife and all that. So most of the data is out. Netaji's case is entirely different. The problem, the very fact I've given reasons, it is going to implicate a lot of people. You have a friendly foreign nation involved. Now, God forbid, I said, that the dominant theory that Netaji was in Russia and where he was killed there. If that is true, then which government would have the guts to bring it out? It's going to have the repercussion. And these are the words. The Home Secretary in 2005, what he was told on record, it is the Home Secretary himself writing it would lead to law and order problem across the country. I am going to take the word for law, the Home Secretary to be true. Some researcher, some historian was telling me, I don't believe the Home Secretary. I said, who are you? Do you know who is Home Secretary? Home Secretary is in charge of IB, he's in charge of the internal security of the country. If the Home Secretary of the country is making a statement on record in writing, it is going to lead to law and order problem. It is gospel truth. It is gospel. He's far more intelligent and far more, he has got much more data available than any historian would have in his archive. So this is how it is. So it is going to hit. So I concede that thing. It is going to see what has happened in last couple of months. Only couple of files have come out. And look what has happened in last 6-7 months. Few files have come out and it's become a national rage. People like me who are nowhere in the scene suddenly have been thrown into limelight. Because nobody else is willing to stick his neck out on this case.
Anuj, first of all, I would like to commend you for the awesome work that you guys are doing. Okay. Having said that, I just have a question for you. Do you think these files that are coming out right now, especially the 33 files, will they have anything substantial or they're mere decoys?
These 33 files will give you some more information than my book. That's it. You will have some more additional data here and there because they contain the government's point of view. Why we set up this commission, why it didn't happen, so on and so forth. These 33 files will give you some interesting snippets here and there, but don't expect that you have these 33 files of the country, the issues or what. No, it will not. It will give you more information than my book. That's it. Biggest cover up. Nothing else.
What about the files that the government is supposed to contact UK and USSR for? Do you believe that's going to happen?
The Prime Minister said, I was there when the Prime Minister said that because in this PM's residence we went.
Right.
He made a clear statement ki, I am going to take up the issue of Netaji with the Russian government.
Correct.
When I'm meeting Mr. Putin in December this year, I will personally raise the issue. So we regard it to be a very big leap, small step for them, but giant leap for us. that we are going to raise the issue. And in fact, Sushma has already raised the issue. So nobody knows the intricacy. But then, yes, if the country's president is going, the head of the government is going to raise the issue, it's going to be relevant. And the good thing, they have shown, you know, they have walked the talk, already walked the, started to walk the talk. They have released their files, and then they're talking to Russians. You know, you should release, in fact, the ideal way to go about it should be that we should declassify all our files, intelligence, and then we should talk to the Russians about it. Unless you people showing your cards on the table, Russians will not give you anything. And why should they? This is our problem, not there.
Thank you.
So, there.
Mr. Anuj, great work. Thanks for all the hard work done. To everybody, a few people had question on why should we declassify, why should we worried about Netaji. I think it's high time the nation understands importance of knowing what really happened. Mr. Kennedy was dead. At least we don't even know how Mr. Netaji, who fought for the country, died or didn't die, got tortured, all that stuff. So one other point that I wanted to make is on all the noted historians and intellectuals, the so-called tolerance, intolerance, all of them peddled the lies. All of them were stooges. I don't hesitate to say they were stooges of the previous governments. If history is thought for 3-4 generations that Netaji kept died 45 and everybody knew it, it's a massive fraud on the nation. And for this level of fraud, I'm happy that some of them are returning awards, but the rest of the crowd should be stripped of all of their awards. Everybody who's there, all of those crowd should be stripped of those awards. So great work done, and wish you all the success in getting to the truth.
I can only answer one point. There was a court of, there's a case in court of law, Nexal. Some Nexal had died 40 years back, and the case was reopened in the court. And I've quoted a judgment, the Kerala High Court. Truth cannot be hidden forever in the name of justice and transparency and so on and so forth. I mean, why should we try to find out what happened to Arushi, by the way? What difference going to make to your and my life? Somebody died, and the crime you have to settle, something has gone wrong. I mean, just because it's been 30, 40 years, in fact, we keep saying, you know what happened after Rajiv Gandhi was, you know, assassinated? I mean, I'm people talk about conspiracy theories. In fact, this issue was, you know, dubbed as conspiracy theory, and I got an entire chapter in a book about conspiracy theories. I give you the biggest conspiracy theory ever to come out from the Indian side. Our home minister, can you imagine? India's home minister stood up in parliament, and he first had a go that Rajiv Gandhi was a very great leader. And America was afraid of Rajiv Gandhi. Shakal dekha aapne sheeshe mein aap logon ne? In Rajiv Gandhi's time, 90% of people used to defecate in the public. This was India's, even now they have 60% record. You don't have, people don't have more than 2 hours a day you get water in Delhi. Rajiv Gandhi was a very big leader, America was afraid of him. And he implicated in attitudes of America in Rajiv Gandhi's killing. And then Government of India formed what is called multidisciplinary some body in which you have people from RAW, NIB, CBI, and they commit doing an inquiry about the conspiracy behind Rajiv Gandhi's assassination. It is going even now. Past 15 years, I don't know how much money they have spent. So then nobody asked this question, ki, why are you wasting so much of public money? What is the need for it? Wait, why should you take out a candle march for Jessica Lal? Because justice. Somebody was killed by somebody who was powerful. So these are the same reasons. For the reason you want to know the truth about Arushi and Jessica Lal and, you know, anybody, same thing with Subhash Chandra Bose. Only difference is this man fought for the country. And because it was not possible, see, demand for declassification could not have been raised in the tolerant times. Indira Gandhi, the first time the demand was made was Suresh Chandra Bose. You did not have the word called declassification, but Suresh Chandra Bose, Netaji's elder brother, he was part of Shahnaz committee. He wrote his report in which he said, don't believe me, my views ki my brother did not die, he was in Russia. Let this government make all the records public. If Nehru was such a Democrat, why did not he heed to that demand? We should have set an example. See, being the nation of Mahatma Gandhi and Ahimsa, we should set up example before the rest of the world. We are preaching the entire world, you know, everything, solution, India, the land of Buddha and Gandhi has the answer. Please show, demonstrate, walk the talk. So you start with this domain, make everything public. Why should we hide? Why should IB and RAW hide anything?
Hello, sir. Excuse me. I just want to ask you one small question. Anusaf, I really appreciate your courage and what you have told just now. It's a very courageous thing you have done. But since our childhood, we have heard that Chacha Nehru ki to hamare desh mein kafi ek tarike se pooja hoti thi aur काफी बड़े लीडर मारे गए हैं, आज आप जो इतने बड़े बड़े उनके ऊपर एलिगेशंस लगा रहे हैं तो काफी बहुत ज्यादा सीरियस है मेरे हिसाब से। और ये बात बिल्कुल सही है जो उन साहब ने बोली है कि इससे हमारे देश को भी बहुत बहुत नुकसान होगा जो अगर ये बातें इस तरीके से खुलेंगी। दूसरी बात मैं कहना चाहता हूँ कि आपने जो मिस्टर अय्यर के बारे में कहा है कि उन्होंने ऐसे जो सुभाष चंद्र साहब को जितना भी गोल्ड मिला था हमारे देश के लोगों ने जो दिया था उनको भी उन्होंने सेव करने की कोशिश करी, तो ये तो एक बहुत ही खतरनाक किस्म का एलिगेशन है। क्या आप वाकई इसमें सच समझते हैं कि इन चीजों में कुछ सच्चाई है?
नहीं, प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड माय पॉइंट। आई मेक प्रेजेंटेशन, एक्चुअली आई शो पीपल स्लाइड्स एंड टॉक। आई एम नॉट कस्टम टू गिविंग लेक्चर बिकॉज़ वेरी कॉम्प्लिकेटेड इश्यूज, वेरी वेरिड, आई हैव टू कवर एवरीथिंग। व्हेन आई टेल यू दैट मिस्टर नेहरू डिड दैट, आई हैव गॉट अ डॉक्यूमेंट फॉर इट। सो यू हैव डॉक्यूमेंट्स अवेलेबल विद द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एक्सटर्नल अफेयर्स इन विच इट इज क्लियरली मेंशन दैट रामामूर्ति अय्यर कर्नल फिगिस दे आर ऑल पार्ट ऑफ द लूट। इनफैक्ट देयर वाज अ नोटिंग वाज मेड बाय शिवशंकर मेनन ससुर जी who was then foreign secretary eventually. So you have records available. So Arun Jaitley made a statement when this Colgate thing was happening. He said, records do not disappear, they're made to disappear. I wonder where was Mr. Jaitley when Bajpayee's government came to know several files concerning Subhash Bose's death records and INA gold and INA property were missing. See, files don't go missing from the PM's office just like that. Now we also have an instance on record. Pandit Nehru's master file on Subhash Bose was destroyed when Indira Gandhi was a prime minister. There was Khosla Commission functioning. Rather than giving the file to the commission, the file was destroyed. Now, what do you do? Now, I think in those days, Panditji was very lucky because you did not have vibrant media. Nobody could, you know, say such thing publicly. If you had Times Now or Aaj Tak in those days, you would have been in big trouble. There were many scandals. I think Ram Guhaji yesterday made some statements about he was comparing things which are very bad in our times. He said these things didn't happen previously. I'm sorry, they happened. Who told you that there were no killings in Lahore previous times? I've heard people getting, you know, bumped off because of Subhash Bose case. Things have happened. I heard he said there's a great difference. I'm sorry that you did not hear me correctly. What I said, what? Mr. Ram Guha made a statement. I also heard him, I was here. No, I agree with what he said. Listen to me. You are right. What I'm saying, what he said was, there's a difference between this today's, what's happening today and last time. There were no killings previously. I said, that's not right. There were killings in previously also. I'm not concerned. I like him. I'm not concerned with that thing. So, yes. Oh, let's not bring Nathuram Godse here. Who mentions?
Manohar Malgaonkar. Okay. He mentions that Netaji worked for British. Is that true?
No.
He says that Manohar Malgaonkar.
No, there's nothing. No, there are many theories, many people can make any allegations. There are, so nothing to substantiate that thing. Why would he work with the British? He was fighting the British.
No, he has also done a lot of research work like you, and if you simply say no,
you have to give me data. Somebody is saying, for example, somebody has made allegations. Now, somebody told me that Mr. So and so was bumped off in these times. How can I answer that?
It has come in black and white. You cannot deny that.
Anuj, I have a question.
No one can question.
You give me data. Since you say that, you give me data that Nehru, Subhash Bose worked for the British. What is the data behind it? Okay, go ahead.
It is in the book. And
I have never read that book.
Anuj, I have a question regarding.
There's a book which says that ISKCON was set up by the CIA. You want to believe in that?
Anuj, here, this side.
I have come across nothing. I can speak for myself. I have come across nothing whatsoever to suggest that Subhash Bose had any linkage with the British other than he was trying to, you know, uproot the British Empire from India. My dear fellow, you just tell me what has he written, because I give you an example. There's a Pulitzer Award winning American journalist who made a statement that Subhash Chandra Bose was captured by the American forces and killed. There's nothing to substantiate. It's all cock and bull story. So just because he's a Pulitzer Award winning doesn't mean I'll follow his words.
Anuj,
eminent historians can say anything, but you have to demonstrate how it's true. I am demonstrating. Whatever I say, I show you documents. I mean, it's just that today I'm not showing you documents.
Anuj, yes, this side, I have a question. From the time this Netaji Subhash Bose files has come up in the media, there was a point of time like 10 or 15 years ago when people used to talk about Netaji Subhas Bose. Congress people used to come and say Subhas Bose was dear to as much dear as Nehru was. But after like in last few years, you have all these leftist media and leftist liberals. For example, what our gentleman said, some eminent writer wrote about this Subhas Chandra Bose being a British agent. Same way, you have a lot of these leftist writers writing a lot about Aryan Dravidian theory, which actually does not exist. So I really don't consider like whether he was eminent or not. What factual background he have? Opinions we can differ, but on fact you can't differ. Either you are right or we will be right. And my question to you regarding how to counter this counter-narrative being started by so-called, according to me, so-called left intellectuals and pro-Congress and paid intellectuals. This, that Subhas Chandra Bose was a British agent, then he wanted to become Nazi agent, but he couldn't be successful because Hitler, because his combination with Hitler did not match. So how to counter this? Can you please light us on that?
I think the only way you can attack, because now people are beginning to do that thing. They think they're very smart. You know, they attack Subhas Bose because they have got one, you know, according to the weak ground, that Subhas Bose went to the Japanese and the Germans, Nazi Germans, and these guys are really bad. I think these people have no understanding of the concepts of national security. You tend to assume that India is a nation of Mahatma Gandhi and that we have been doing all these good things, you know, from the past 47 years. I give you an example. How many Indians did Hitler kill? Give me an answer.
That Congresses or people like Markande Kardju can answer.
Hitler was evil. Hitler was responsible for the Holocaust. Hitler was not responsible for killing even a single Indian. It was a long, you know, even before Hitler came to power, the Nazi Germans, the German government was supporting the Indian freedom fighters in their own national interest. How many people do you think, you know, Mr. Musharraf was, you know, guilty of, you know, Indians? He, head of the enemy state of ours. When Mr. Musharraf came to India, we gave him a guard of honor. And that is called diplomacy. And when Subhas Chandra Bose goes to Germany to take help from it, that becomes an immoral act. And when Mrs. Gandhi goes to Saddam Hussein, who's as bad a guy in the eyes of the Western countries as Hitler is, that becomes a diplomatic, you know, coup. Mrs. Gandhi shaking hands with Saddam Hussein. As we talk, do you know the heads of Indian intelligence and ISI, they meet in foreign countries? Would Gandhiji would have approved of this thing? Let's talk. I'm very open to talk about national security. I mean, if you're talking, give me one person from IB and RAW and Ministry of External Affairs, any foreign secretary of India, saying that Subhas Chandra Bose's approach to Nazi Germany was a negative move or a bad thing. It's only historians who have no idea what national security is all about. See, in national security, you need to make these kind of, you know, when you do business, you do these things, you have to take these steps.
That way,
India was not become, America was not supporting us. America was dead against Indian freedom struggle. We were doing nothing. Roosevelt had some interest, but they were not interested. Churchill was responsible, the man who was the British Prime Minister in 1940, that relevant time. He was responsible for killing of a lot of people in our country. Millions died because of the man-made famine. Now, I am strange country. I am not concerned about my people dying. I am more concerned about the Jews dying in other country. खाने को रोटी नहीं पेट के अंदर अब चलें विश्व गुरु बनने के अंदर ये दिमाग से निकाल दीजिए सुभाष बोस ने गांधी के बारे में यही लिखा था अपना चिंता करो पहले अपना नेशनल इंटरेस्ट पहले दूसरे का बाद में खाने को रोटी नहीं है जाके यूनाइटेड नेशन में जी एटम बम खत्म कर दो ये कर दो वो कर दो अरे अपनी चिंता करो पहले आप लोग आपके यहाँ तो कुछ है नहीं है आपने नहीं काम किया नेशनल सिक्योरिटी में आपका लंका में क्या हुआ था महिंदा राजपाक्से he was killing your own brothers and sisters Tamil and government of India supplying him arms and ammunition and they were accused of war crimes वो क्या है वो कहेंगे नेशनल इंटरेस्ट में किया था हमने तो आपने जैसे नेशनल इंटरेस्ट में काम किया उस आदमी ने भी नेशनल इंटरेस्ट में काम किया था आप करें इस पे डिबेट की लगे हम चाह रहे हैं कि खुल के डिबेट हो इसके ऊपर
हाय अनुजा
लास्ट वन सर आई सर माई प्रॉब्लम इज की दैट आई हैव टू मेक अ प्रेजेंटेशन टू देयर थ्री थ्योरीज ए माई कंक्लूजन ए There was no plain cash. B, it is clearly evident from available information, Subhas Chandra Bose was Russia bound. Three, it is my conclusion as a journalist and whatever I have seen, he was in Russia. I heard from places, people, and I've got something support. Fourth, I think the story about this Faizabad is true, but to explain that, you have to give me 3 hours time. So it's
Anuj,
not possible for. No, you said Mr. T and Rameshwar Nath Kaur told the ambassador. I don't believe Mr. Rameshwar Nath Kaur. Rameshwarnath Kau was like Mr. Malik. I give you example. Mr. Malik, I have demonstrated in my book, Malik was the boss of Mr. R.N. Kau. Mr. Malik lied through his teeth before Khosla Commission. I have demonstrated that thing. Mr. Kau would be the same category. Thank you very much for your time. I'm sorry this was the... It is not my format to talk like that. I give presentation and then explain because I disseminate information, but thank you very much for your patience and time. So kind
Anuj, in fact, thank you so much. And I apologize that many of you still have your questions unanswered, but ye to hona hi tha because this is not a session that can end so easily. Rather than answers, it has opened the scope for so many more questions. And that will have to be taken offline, including you. Because we are believing that we have to keep the session, every session on time, that it starts and ends on time as well. Thank you so much, Anuj. Thanks a ton. And I'm sure you will be available in case everyone has a one-on-one question. Full of eye-openers, revelations, you could say shockers. And thank you so much for familiarizing many of us with Netaji and telling us so much more about him. Thank you once again.